Hi everyone, welcome back to Earl Grey Books. I'm Ellie and today it is time for my general November wrap up. Basically this month I thought instead of doing a mid-month wrap up I would do a fiction one and a non-fiction one because of non-fiction November. We'll get into why that was maybe a bad idea in the non-fiction one, but we have a lot of books to talk about today, so we're just gonna jump into it. I read 20 in total. What is this piece of hair doing? Three of which were rereads. Okay, I also read a couple of books from my Kindle, starting with Only When It's Us by Chloe Leese. Gave this one 4 stars, was reading it as part of a post, which I'll link below, in which my best friend chose a bunch of romance books for me to read. I chose some for her to read, and voila. So yes, that post will be linked below if you're interested in hearing more of my thoughts about that. There's a couple here that are part of posts, so I won't talk about those ones too much, because yeah, this is gonna be a long video. Next up, I read Miss Austin by, it's either Gil Hornby or Jill Hornby, not sure which one. This follows Cassandra Austin in two sort of separate timelines. One when her sister Jane is still alive, and another 23 years after her death, and some letters resurface. This was okay, gave it 3.5. I really liked it at the start, and then I just kind of didn't. I think my biggest criticism of it is that it doesn't really feel like it's about Jane Austen. Like she doesn't feel like a real person in here, and neither does anyone else. So it was okay, didn't love it. Then we have some romance, of course. This is One Night with a Prince by Sabrina Jeffries. Mentioned this one in my last historical romance haul. This is the third and final book in this series. I had ordered it, it got lost in the mail, and I had to wait like an extra 3 months for it to arrive. But I finally read it. And this is probably my least favorite of the series, but it's still really good. And I'm just happy because now I can finally continue with all these other Sabrina Jeffries books that I have just here that I've been waiting for. We jump into some poetry now. This is kind of poetry, I guess. This is Autobiography of Red by Anne Carson, which is a novel in verse. This was my first little foray into Anne Carson, and this was incredible. I think probably one of the best books I've read this year, but also just one of the most like masterful things I've ever read. It's definitely a book that I couldn't tear myself away from. I started reading it one afternoon and I was just like, I'm just gonna read a couple of pages because I had like finished something earlier that day and I just wasn't really in the mood for like another nonfiction book or another novel at that point. And I was like, I'll just try it. And then I read the entire thing in a sitting. So loved it. Not letting myself buy books until February, crossing fingers that that goes well. But I think then I will pick up some more Anne Carson, and it gives me a little time to work out which one to go for. More poetry and a reread. This is Citizen by Claudia Rankine. I did another post in which I reread books that I never reviewed. Love this one. Think this is one of the best poetry. It's not really a collection. Yeah, one of the best pieces of poetry I've ever read. 4.5 stars for it. I think this is something that everyone should read. It's incredible. And yeah, I mean, I've talked about this before. I really, really enjoy it. And I will link that post below as well if you're interested in some more eloquent thoughts. Back to some romance, which was really the only thing I was in the mood for this month, if I was completely honest. This is A Rogue of One's Own by Evie Dunmore. I buddy read this with Angel and we did a discussion on her blog, so I'll also link that below. I love this series. Gave this one 4.5 as well. It's just one of those series that makes me really, really happy. And yeah, I just love them. So I love that as well. These have a little bit of meat to them. It talks a lot about the suffragette movement, and I learnt a lot about that that I didn't know before, but in a way that was interesting and it didn't feel like I was learning about it. So love this series, cannot wait for the next one, which comes out next year. The Viscount Who Loved Me by Julia Quinn. This is book 2 in the Bridgerton series. I wasn't gonna buy these until the end of the month, and then I ended up caving because I don't know if anyone knows this, please let me know in the comments, but I'm not sure what the upcoming Netflix series follows as to whether it follows just the first book or whether it kind of puts all of them together. So I've kind of been reading them. Yes, unfortunately missed out on the 3rd and 4th. They won't arrive until Christmas, which is the release date for the Netflix series, so I may end up reading them as ebooks, and then just, you know, when they get here, they get here. But love this one. I love Anthony. I think I might have enjoyed this one even more than The Duke and I. I just love him so much. I think he's really funny, and really enjoyed reading that. Okay, and then I read It's Hard Out Here for a Duke by Maya Rodel. I didn't like this one at all. I gave it 2 stars. I was bored out of my brain, and also just like, I just didn't really like anything. This is the 4th book in the series, but it seems to take place first chronologically, and I just, yeah, not gonna be reading the rest of this series. And then back to a series that I love. This is Tempt Me at Twilight by Lisa Kleypas. This is the 3rd book in the Hathaway series. I read the 2nd one in like August or something, and I didn't really like it. I'd loved the 1st one, but I didn't really like the 2nd, and I'm happy that I really liked this one again. So this one follows Poppy, and it was just really cute and I loved it. So very excited to be starting the 4th one, hopefully in the coming days. I would really love to finish this series by the end of the year, but we'll see how that goes. I've got 2 books left. I think I can do it. Another one that I reread was Soulless by Gail Carriger. This was also part of that rereading books I never reviewed post. I wasn't sure whether I was gonna like this one because I had read this at a time where I didn't read romance, and this is a steampunk romance. So yeah, I wasn't sure that I'd like it now that I've read more from the genre and that I'm definitely a historical romance reader. I don't really like anything else. But I actually really, really like this. I think I definitely liked it more for the historical feel than the steampunk elements. But I still really loved it. I do have to say that I was a little bit struck by how similar it was in times to the Infernal Devices series. This one came out first. Like, there was just quite a few elements that were quite similar. They're very different books, but it was just like, you can tell that they were kind of written around the same time, where like steampunk was this big thing and there's like vampires and werewolves and all that sort of stuff. So it was just funny to me to kind of see that. And I think they were both published 2011-2012. It was really interesting to see kind of how they played off each other. Some more poetry. This is Dearly by Margaret Atwood. Obviously, Margaret Atwood is one of my favorite authors. I haven't actually read anything from her this year until now. just because I don't really know. I've just had other things to read. But I had to get this as soon as it came out. Loved it. Never read any of her poetry before. But I really, really enjoyed this, and yeah, some of them, yeah, not really for me, but others I really, really liked. Last ebook was A War by Laura Thalassa. I read Pestilence last month, really loved it. I wasn't gonna read this one until December, but then I was just like feeling it, so I read it, loved it. Really, really loved it. And I will be picking up the third book, Famine, probably tonight, to be honest, because I am in the mood for it. So really, really like this. Really loving this series so far. Very different. Like I said, I only really read historical romance. Trying to branch out, really liking this. I guess it's kind of like fantasy apocalypse sort of thing. It's about the four horsemen of the apocalypse, so yeah, really like this. And then finally finished the month off with a reread, which was The Guinevere Deception by Kirsten White, one of my favorite books of last year. Still absolutely love this, and read it in the space of a couple of hours, just like I did the first time around. Was rereading this in preparation for the second book, which I was hoping to start in the last few days of the month, but didn't get to. So I have two more books that I really want to finish before I start that one, just so that I'm not reading, I mean, I'm always reading like 20, but so I'm trying to consolidate by the end of the year. And yes, hopefully I will talk about that one in my mid-month wrap-up in December. But loved this as always, very excited for that one. And there we are, that is the general wrap-up. And like I mentioned, I will have a non-fiction one up that will be up on the 4th, and I'm gonna go film it now. So I will see you all tomorrow. I'm gonna be talking about some of the books for 2021 that I'm really excited for. Okay, bye.